any such initiative would probably be limited to certain types of IT products, and I would likely involve some form of pricing constraints. Whereas in exposed investigations, we have all sorts of case-specific evidence and economic analysis on which to base our decisions, we are forced to look at more general data and arguments when assessing the impact of ex-ante legislation. And just to be clear, ladies and gentlemen, while it is still early days, it is certainly possible that I will go for a legislative proposal. I'm not the one who wants to make only regulations, legislations, and what have you, but I'm not fearing to do it if it's the only way. And that could have a profound impact on the concerned industry. So it's not a decision taken lightly, that for sure, but be aware that that for me is also one of the instruments in the basket. And many of you work for companies that could be concerned by such a measure. So I invite you, here we are, buddies, to let me have your views and to give me certainty that we can tackle it. There are 5 framework measures we are looking at in order to increase the benefits we can reap from interoperability. Of course, interoperability and standards are important concepts across almost all parts of the digital agenda. For example, we want to achieve interoperability for cross-border e-health applications and for smart energy meters. And the benefits of those actions will not only be economic, they will also fundamentally shape our future quality of life. And will she really be able to put all of that, you may ask? I wonder sometimes, but at the end of the day, it's a matter of leadership, mentioned by Graham. We can't change all of this in 1 year, but my term in office is 5. And there will be plenty who try to stop change. And I still want that change. And I will keep coming back and speaking to you until we achieve it. And the most fascinating experience so far in this portfolio was attending one of the events the Spanish presidency has organized. It was in Madrid. The Spanish presidency had invited 800 European young researchers and innovators and startups. And they were offered hotel accommodation and so on. And the 800 said, no way, we are not